Hello everyone, Michael here with the Daily Note 2 YouTube channel, and welcome to another episode of Galaxy Note 2 Tips and Tricks, episode 25. Yesterday I showed you how to access functions of Google Now almost hands-free. You first had to reach into your pocket and hit the power button or the home button for it to work. And I understood that a lot of you thought, you wished it could be better, and I actually found a better way, so I just wanted to share that. So it is through an app called Headset Button Control, and it is about $3, but I think if you are looking for that hands-free functionality, it is definitely going to be a really nice feature to add onto your Galaxy Note. So let me just demonstrate. Imagine this phone was in your pocket, so I'm going to shut it off, and then I programmed it in so that when you do three clicks, it activates Google Now. And then we're going to do a couple of functions. Weather. Okay, I'm not sure if you heard the response, but there was an audio response there. Okay, and let's do one more thing. Note to self, get a haircut. Okay, and we have to wait a little bit for this thing to set. Okay, and say that this is in your pocket, the screen is on, you wanted to turn the screen off. Just do four presses here. Okay, so I just want to show you how I was able to achieve all that. And let me show you this app. Okay, so just go to the market and go to look for headset button or headphone control. So you could see that there's headset button control trial. You could try it for, I'm not sure how long, it doesn't indicate here, but if you really like it, it's about $3. So let me show you what settings I have in here. Now, I thought the easy controls were not as customizable as I thought, so I have it on advanced. So where you want to go into is the center button actions. Go to center button actions, and I did not touch the single click or the double click, but instead I think I disabled the long click there, but on the triple click and quadruple click I said these controls. So let's go into triple click for default command, right? I searched voice search, or I selected voice search. Okay, when you select voice search, it asks you if you want to turn the screen on, and of course I need that to work. And then the quadruple click. So what I used the quadruple click was to turn off the screen. If you want to turn it off, you need this other app. It's free. Okay, the app is called Screen Off. Okay, so once again, just search for Screen Off. Okay, and it's called Screen Off and Lock, and as you can see, I have this installed. Then I opened that app one time, I gave it the administrator privileges, and that's all you really need to do. So after you do that, you need to go back to this app, right? And we want to program the quadruple click with the screen off. Okay, so you want to do launch app, then you want to select screen off. Screen off, and of course you don't want to wake your screen up, right? So you want to click no there. Okay, so we have that all set, and then do a double triple click. Note to self, buy pizza. Okay, and as you can see, if this were in your pocket, you cannot shut it off right away. Remember, you just need to wait maybe 5 seconds, and then you could do the four taps. Okay, and then it works fine like that. Now let me show you possible problems that you'll run into. So say you do the triple click here to do the Google Now. Okay, you know, 1 out of 10 times, or maybe if you don't use it for a while, you'll see that you click on 3 times and it fails to start recognizing your voice. So you might need to do the triple click again. And as you can see, it initialized there, no problem. But sometimes it fails to trigger the mic. And that's one thing you'll notice. And the other problem is when you have the screen off, right, and you do the triple click, okay, it actually doesn't unlock your screen. It just goes behind it. So the screen is typically still locked. So, but, you know, you could actually go to all these, you could go to anything really, but the screen actually is unlocked, or is still locked in the background. So the only function that you'll notice that responds a little differently is when you hold on the home button, doesn't do anything. It should pop up with that task in the recent apps list, and it doesn't do that. So you could get around that. If you notice that your phone is not responding to the hold right on the home screen to bring up the task, it is because the screen is still locked in the background, and you just need to just hit the home button. You can see a little blip there. There was a slight blip. It showed the home screen for a second, and it actually unlocked the screen when you hit that home button. So once again, I'm going to hold the home button, and now it brings up the task manager. Okay, so that is the end of this episode. I just want to show you one more thing. So currently, without this app, right, and without this added functionality, you cannot choose artists or navigate through your music player, but you could add that on here. So say that you want to do the unlock with the three tabs. Play Maroon 5. Okay. So yeah, you could definitely add that functionality, and it's hard to show you just how nice this feature is, but once you take it outside and when you start navigating with this little thing without taking out the phone, it'll bring a big smile to your face, and you'll realize it is a big feature that you just added onto this phone. So anyway, that's the end of this video. I hope you got something out of it. So if you haven't been to my channel yet, please come to my channel, check out my other 90 plus videos. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe, because I do actually create an episode like this every day so that you could get the most out of your brand new Samsung Galaxy Note 2. And I do have a new Twitter account now, so just for this channel. So please come by and follow me on Twitter. You'll get notified when I create a new episode. Okay, once again, thank you for watching.